Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Nate the Lighting Guy coming to you with a second tutorial on how to use the Novation Launchpad Pro with QLC Plus. This time, I'll show you how to program the buttons on the Launchpad Pro and afterwards use those buttons to control an LED PAR fixture. Before we begin, make sure you have your Launchpad Pro properly connected and set up with QLC Plus. If you haven't done this or don't know how, you can watch my first video on how to connect the Novation Launchpad Pro to QLC Plus, and the link is in the description. Also, you may want to have an RGB PAR hooked up via DMX and ready to go as well. I'm using a simple 86 RGB LED PAR you could find on eBay and Amazon pretty easily. Now that we're set up, let's begin. First, you will add the PAR light you want to control, which for me is the TMS RGB LED PAR on Universe 1. Go over to the Functions tab. Next, we'll create the background scene for the launchpad, which will light the buttons in the colors that control the LED PAR. Create a new scene and call it Background. I'm also going to add Startup Scene to the title so I remember to set it to automatically start when we launch Operate Mode in QLC Plus. Add the Launchpad Pro. Click its tab and enable all channels. And find where you want the three color buttons to go. Set the first one to red, the second one to green. I'll turn off the light so you can see the launch pad light up a little better. And the third one to blue. This is the scene that we want when all the functions are off. We want to change the color of each individual button to white when we press it. To do this, add a new scene and call it Red Button Light. Add the Launchpad Pro. Make sure you know what channel you used for the red button. Check back to the background scene if needed for reference. The red button in my case is channel 44. Only enable channel 44 and set it to white. The reason why we enable only this channel is so that it doesn't interfere with other button lights when activated. Clone the red button light and rename it to green button light. Disable channel 44 and enable the next channel and set it to the same value. Now clone the green button light and rename it to blue button light. Disable channel 45 and enable the next channel and set it to the same value. One of the easiest ways to assign launchpad buttons to functions and make it easy to edit is to create a new collection for each of the buttons. Create a new collection and call it Red Button Control. Clone it and rename it Green Button Control. Clone the Green Button Control and rename it to Blue Button Control. Stay on the Blue Button Control collection and add the Blue Button Light scene. Click the Green Button Control collection and add the Green Button Light scene. Click the Red Button Control collection and add the Red Button Light scene. Before we jump to the Virtual Console, we'll set the startup scene by clicking the green flag at the top, which is the Select Startup function. and clicking the background startup scene. Keep in mind, if you want to assign buttons to your lighting programs with the Launchpad, make sure you add them to the collections which the buttons control, and do not remove the button light scene because it's what makes the button change color when enabled. Now go over to the Virtual Console, add a new button matrix, click the plus sign to add functions, select all three collection functions, and hit OK. Change the horizontal button count to 3 and the vertical button count to 1 and hit OK. The buttons may go out of order from red, green, and blue. Simply drag them around until they match your background colors that you set up on the Launchpad. Right-click Red Button Control and select Widget Properties. In External Input, click Auto Detect and press the button that you assigned in the background scene to red on the Launchpad. Click OK and repeat for the other two buttons. You have now set the three RGB buttons so that they will turn to white when enabled and go back to the background color when off. To test this, switch QLC Plus to operate mode. Now when we hit an assigned button on the Launchpad, it should light up white and activate the functions assigned in its collection. That's pretty cool. Why not take it a step further and program the controls for that RGB PAR I said I was going to use? Click the red X button on the top to stop all functions and hit the stop button to bring QLC Plus out of operate mode. Click the Functions tab. Add a new scene and call it LED PAR Red. Add the 86 RGB LED PAR, or whatever PAR you decided to use. Click its tab and enable only the necessary channels to make it red, which for me is intensity and red, and turn them all the way up. Clone LED PAR Red and rename it LED PAR Green. Disable the red channel, enable the green channel, and turn it all the way up. Clone LED PAR Green and rename it to LED PAR Blue. Disable the green channel, enable the blue channel, and turn it all the way up. We have now created the three scenes that control the main colors the LED PAR runs. Let's add these functions to the button collections so we can turn them on. Click the red button control collection and add the scene LED PAR Red. Click the green button control collection and add the scene LED PAR Green. Click the blue button control collection and add the scene LED PAR Blue. That's the last thing we had to do. If this was set up properly, we can now use the Launchpad Pro to trigger each of the three colors and get feedback to indicate if they've been turned on. Click on the Virtual Console tab and set QLC Plus to operate mode and let's give it a try. Press the buttons and see if they change color to white on the Launchpad Pro, and see if the PAR light responds to the buttons you assigned. And that's all there is to it. In case you had trouble designing the program, here's a little troubleshooting section. When you created the three collections and go over to the Virtual Console tab and add the button matrix, but cannot find the three collections when trying to add them, make sure the collections checkbox is checked in the filter area. After doing this, you should now be able to add them. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to program buttons on the Novation Launchpad Pro with QLC Plus. If you like this video, please be sure to subscribe, and feel free to comment if you have any questions on what I did in this video. Until next time, I'm Nate the Lighting Guy, and thanks for watching.